Hey everybody, it's Michaela Velas from Better Homes and Gardens, and today I'm going to be talking to you about the top 10 bars in Midtown Sacramento. So, I actually just moved here back in June, so I have, and before I make this video, I just want to say everybody please drink responsibly and know your limits, but when I go out, I usually just have one drink and then that's good, so be responsible about it, but these are kind of the staples that I would say make up Midtown. So even if you don't choose to go here for a drink, I would highly recommend it. Food, appetizers, atmosphere, you can't go wrong. So I'm gonna do top 10. I'm gonna start from number 10 and just work my way down to number one. So I really love Cupero's, and I have a list, so if I look down, that's what I'm referring to. So Cupero's is my number 10. A lot of people love Cupero's. They're like, let's go to Cupero's. That's like a really big go-to. They have a really good beer called Cabrew. I never know how to say it, but it's actually really good. I would really recommend it. My number 9 is going to be the Mimosa House, just because they have this little tiny mimosa. It's called the Cinderella, and it's blue, and there's cotton candy in it, and it's really good. And then when I went one time with my friend, she got the sour gummy bear apple one. It's just like kind of a fun little thing if you like to try new things. That's a really good place to go to. If you're more, they also have normal mimosas too, so if that's not really your thing, good mimosas at the Mimosa House, I'd really recommend it. And I think the one in Sacramento is actually the original. So Dive Bar is my number 8. This is a total staple in Sacramento. I mean, I've known about this forever. And it's basically where these mermaids just swim in the glass and they talk to you and they wave. It's about every 30 minutes, but I've known about that since I was little because I know my older siblings and my parents would go out to Sacramento and they would tell me about the mermaids swimming in the glass. So when I turned 21 a couple years ago, I was all, oh, I want to go see that. So I did that for my 21st. It's definitely something really cool. You should go check it out. My number 7 is Public House. So I would get the Blonde Transfusion beer here. That's my favorite. You can't go wrong with that. The staff is really sweet here. I would recommend this place to anybody. Number 6 is Tank House. So Tank House is actually getting more and more popular. It used to be kind of just the locals knew about it, but they have great staff. Everyone's super friendly. It's definitely a staple of Midtown, and it's kind of like where you walk up, you order what you want, and then you can either go sit at a booth inside or you can go sit outside. Love Tank House. Red Rabbit is my number 5. So I love Red Rabbit just because it's so close. It's in walking distance. They have a great patio, great atmosphere, and I would recommend it. My number 4 is Lowbrow. So a lot of these, I was a cheerleader growing up in high school. I went to Wood Creek, so it was probably about 30 minutes from SAC. I mean, a lot of my friends from high school joined sororities and went to SAC State, and I know that Lowbrow is a fun place to go. It's kind of, I don't want to say it's basic, but it kind of is. It just, there's a pig and it lights up and it's really girly and fun and cute, and you can sit inside and outside. They have live music some nights and you sit under the lights and it's actually really fun. Lowbrow is one of my favorites and I'm so lucky to be so close to it. Ink and Drink is my number 3. So this place, I put this as my number 3 just because I had a really good experience one time. I was with a couple friends and we wanted to go out to brunch to get mimosas. And they wanted to do bottomless and they weren't doing bottomless that day. So my friend was like, oh man, like it's my birthday. I'm really upset now. That's why we went here to celebrate. And the server actually went inside, spoke to the manager, and then she did bottomless for the table. So all about customer service. I mean, we had a great time. We drank responsibly, and I would recommend Ink and Drink. My number 2 is Arlo Craft Brewery. So this was one of the first bars that I went to when I did move to Midtown. And I just really like it here because it's homey. You walk in, the staff greets you. It's so you can sit up at the bar and you can see everyone at the bar and I guess like the guests are really nice and welcoming there too. And then you can go chill out on the patio or you can go get a table if you don't want to sit at the bar. It's just very homey. So I always feel super comfortable when I go in there and I love Arlo Craft. And they have really good beer, obviously. Arlo Craft Brewery. I haven't tried all their beers, so I can't say what to get because when I go there, I just get one. Usually a Moscow. I don't really get the beer. I think I got the beer one time and I can't remember what beer I got, but it was good. So I would go to Arlo Craft Brewery. And finally, my number one, I love Zocalo. So I love Mexican food, but once you pair chips and salsa and you get them free there with Marg's, I love Marg's. I love their Zocalos and they're super big. So I usually go with a friend and then we'll share one and it's really good, so I would recommend Zocalo's. And yeah, those are my top 10 places to go in Midtown. So please like, comment, and subscribe, and let me know if you want me to do more videos like this. And I hope you all have a great day. Okay, bye.